makes you seem safe.
What the fuck? Ah, Jesus Christ. Estate pendiente porque pueden entrar cosas. No tengo la menor idea.
I think Puerto Rico was incredibly successful. I actually think it was one of the best jobs that's ever been done with respect to what this is all about.
Estaba en mi casa y pasamos María dentro de la casa con mi esposo y mi familia. Empezamos a ver la parte de atrás de casa, los palos de aguacate, los cocos, todo lo que se había sembrado para abajo.
Se fue todo.
Sí, se fue todo. Sin luz, sin agua, wow. Casi en casa 8 meses sin luz y agua. Fue fuerte para todo el mundo, porque de verdad que hubieron días que yo me tiraba seca de la sed a buscar un poco de agua y no lo había. No lo había. Decía, Dios mío, que no hay agua para yo beber un poquito.
Bueno, aquí en Arecibo, en Islote, pues María pues sacó bastante arena y destruyó bastante la playa. Y pues con la comunidad como tal, no solamente queda más que una palmita salva, que esa es la de la fe, como nosotros le decimos, a los comerciantes, porque pues nos destruyó la playa y ya casi nadie se para, solamente a tirar fotos, a irse, pero no vienen a consumir, no vienen a disfrutar en familia. Tuvimos que emigrar a Estados Unidos por lo menos 8 meses para que ellos empezaran a estudiar, aprendieran el idioma, que gracias a papito Dios pues aprendieron el idioma y regresamos a la isla pues porque no, pues, teníamos nuestras cosas acá.
The job that FEMA and law enforcement and everybody did working along with the governor in Puerto Rico, I think, was tremendous. I think that Puerto Rico was an incredible unsung success.
I don't think those are the right words when you talk about loss of life.
What is your death count as of this moment? 16 people. You can be very proud of all of your people, all of our people.
As to Puerto Rico, I'd like to find out how many people actually died from the hurricane. That's not a bad question to ask. Is it 16 or is it 3,000? And what led to their deaths and what can we do better? Hurricanes should not be a political issue.
According to a new study, the death toll from Hurricane Maria in Puerto Rico is more than 70 times higher than officials claim.
According to an independent report from George Washington University, commissioned by Puerto Rican officials, nearly 3,000 people died as a result of the hurricane.
20 times the official death toll.
In the weeks after the storm hit, the Puerto Rican government said 64 people died on the island. But mounting evidence suggested that figure failed to take full account of the deadly effects of prolonged power failure, blocked roads, and interrupted health care. Studies estimated the death toll ranged from 800 to more than 4,600. Today, President Trump said 3,000 people did not die in the two hurricanes that hit Puerto Rico. When I left the island after the storm had hit, they had anywhere from 6 to 18 deaths. Mr. Trump said the higher estimates were done by the Democrats in order to make me look as bad as possible. If a person died for any reason, like old age, just add them onto the list. Republican response was largely muted. One exception, Florida Governor Rick Scott, a candidate for the U.S. Senate, who said, "I disagree with POTUS. An independent study said thousands were lost."
Graduate students and researchers went to about 3,000 homes on the island, and they interviewed people. How many people live here? How long did you have electricity? What kind of illnesses do you have?
That's not, so I have no reason to dispute these numbers. I was in Puerto Rico after the hurricane. It was devastated. This was a horrible storm. I toured the entire island. And it's an isolated island that lost its infrastructure and its power for a long time. You couldn't get to people for a long time on the island because roads were washed out, power was gone, and the casualties mounted for a long time.
Well,
How would you grade the White House response so far?
I'd say it was a 10.
Yo diría que estamos en el piso. Mucho más bajito que Santo Domingo. Se nos ha hecho duro, ya tú viste, el turismo está cayéndose porque pues las casas están desastrosas. Humanamente nosotros mismos nos hemos ayudado más que el mismo gobierno nos ha dado la mano, porque ahora en esta vuelta que nos pasó, nosotros queremos construir y no podemos porque ellos no nos lo permiten. Entonces es duro porque tú tienes tu casa y la perdiste. Entonces tú quieres construirla y no te dan el permiso. Más no te dan una vivienda, es duro. Todas las casas que están deshabitadas, el gobierno las está reposeyendo para venderlas en vez de dárselas a las personas de bajos recursos. Eso es algo que está en crítica.
Did the United States, did our government, when we came in, did we do a great job? Military, first responders, FEMA, did we do a great job?
You responded immediately, sir.
He did not do everything that he could
do. So you don't agree?
He stood there besides Donald Trump, and when Donald Trump gave himself a 10 out of a 10, he had a chance to say no, Mr. President. He had one thing, the same thing that you have, the same thing that I have, his voice. And he decided to shut up.
Today, we say enough. Today, we raise our voices for Puerto Rico.
Lots of them. The red, white, and blue of Puerto Rico. Today, Americans of Puerto Rican descent vented that despite the fact all Puerto Ricans back home in Puerto Rico are bona fide American citizens, these days it sure doesn't feel that way. Yes, American aid followed Hurricane Maria, but no, they say, not nearly enough of it. And those images of Donald Trump tossing paper towels to needy Puerto Ricans, an insult.
Yes! It's a disgrace how our government has abandoned the 3.5 million Americans in Puerto Rico. 3.5 million Americans. It's unheard of.
I give ourselves a 10.
The report was critical not only of the central government, but of the municipal government, mm-hmm. of which you lead the largest one on the island. Mm-hmm. Did you do enough, and were you as prepared as you should have been?
I was as prepared as I could have been, but no, I've said it. I didn't do enough. It will never be enough for me. No matter what I did, it will never be enough for me. Because I know, and I'm looking at you in your eyes, that I didn't get to everybody. And because I couldn't get to everybody, people died. So no.
Puerto Rico. We love Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico.
We love you.
And we also love Puerto Rico. Everybody has said it's amazing the job that we've done in Puerto Rico. We're doing a great job. We have had tremendous reviews. The governor made incredible statements about how well we're doing. I think we've done a really good job.
We're doing a really good job. I mean, I think we're really getting really good marks for the work we're doing.
I think it's going really well. We've made tremendous strides. I think it's now acknowledged what a great job we've done. In Texas and in Florida, we get an A+. And I'll tell you what, I think we've done just as good in Puerto Rico. We have done an incredible job. And that's the truth.
Puerto Rico, the island in which I was born, the island that watched me grow up, where I took my first steps, spoke my first words, where I learned about the meaning of life, to run and to love. The island that taught me to appreciate el campo, its mountains, beaches, off-roads, the heat, rain, and all the beauty and capacity in it. Where I studied and will continue to study, where for the first time in my life I fell to the ground but picked myself back up. And remain standing here. The land that feels every tear that falls down my face. The island that I represent and will keep representing with immense pride. My charming little island, but with a heart and talent bigger than the problems it faces. We, the people of Puerto Rico, show Yo soy boricua, pa' que tú lo sepas. We sing La Borinqueña, and recite Preciosa, because it was the place that showed me how to paint life with all the colors of land. Puerto Rico, the island of lamp, island of giants, bless this beautiful island, mi Borinquen. Thank you for the culture, values, endless memories, friendships, and for my family. My dearest island, even though you remain in the dark, the heart of your people give you more light than anything else made by a man. This is why you are and will forever be la isla del encanto.
Sin dueño. Hijos del cañaveral, nunca se nos cae la pava. Esta raza siempre es brava, aunque sople el temporal. Pa' que sientas el calibre de un caballo sin jinete. Mira cómo corre libre, se refleja en el machete.